गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न मल्टीप्लिकेशन। चिल्ड्रन, लेट अस गो।
हाय एवरीवन, आई नीड टू बाय अ न्यू बोल फॉर गोलू। आई होप आई कैन फाइंड समथिंग गुड फॉर हिम हियर। लुक एट गोलू, ही इज थ्रिल्ड टू सी सो मेनी फिश अराउंड। आर दोस क्लाउड फिश? वाओ, they look beautiful. I have never seen so many clownfish at the same time. Let me see how many there are in all. There are two fish in each bowl. And there are four bowls. That means if we add two, four.
That means if we add two, four time we will get the total number of clown fish. There are 8 clown fish in these bowls. Do you know any another way of writing 4 group of 2 is equal to 8? See, we can also write the expression like this is read as 4 is multiple by 2 is 8. This is the multiplication sign.
One, two, four, I need your help.
Okay, what's the problem?
I bought 24 apples at 12 rupees per apple. It took me 5 minutes to calculate the total cost myself. Yes, very funny. 1, 2, 4. I need to find an easier way to multiply numbers.
It may help if you split the numbers. Okay.
Children, shall we help to Bolu? Look here, 24 apples, each one cost 12 rupees. So the total cost is 12 rupees into 24. First, step to arrange the numbers in vertically according to the place value. The greater number on top and smaller number below it. Place the multiplication sign between the two numbers. Now come to the ones place. Here we have 2. So 2 fours are 8. So I write 8 under the ones place. So next, 2 twos are 4, so I write under the tens place 4. Next, take the tens place, here we have 1. So under the ones place we put a 0, then 1 4 is 4. One, two is 2. Finally, we have the two numbers together. Answer 8 plus 0, 8. So under the ones place 8, then 4 plus 4, 8. So under the tens place 8. Then in 100th place we have 2 alone, so I put under the 100th place 2. So our answer is 288 rupees for 24 apples. Therefore 24 apples is equal to rupees 288.
Daisha have come to the airport to receive Pasha's uncle. They are having a good time watching aeroplanes.
Aisha, these aeroplanes are so huge. Do you know how many passengers an aeroplane can carry?
I think one such aeroplane can carry around 325 passengers.
Then how many passengers would all those 23 aeroplanes carry?
Well, that'll be a huge number. To find out, we'll have to multiply 325 by 23.
I can't do this multiplication. It's pretty tough.
Not at all. I'll show you how easy it is. Let me take out my notebook and pencil.
The first step to arrange the numbers in vertically. The greater number on top and the smaller number below it. Place the multiplication sign between the two numbers. Next, assign the place values 1s, 10s, 100s for each digit of two numbers. To start with, we need to multiply the 1s, 10s and 100s of the first number one by one with 1s digit of the second number. In this case, 5 multiplied by 3 gives 15. We write 5 in the 1s column and carry over 1 to the tens column. Next, 2 multiplied by 3 gives 6. We add to 1 that was carry over to the tens column to 6. We get 7. So we write 7 in the tens column. Next, 3 by 3 gives 9. Since there is no carry over, so we directly write the column.
What do we do next?
Next, we multiply the 1s, 10s and 100s of the first number one by one with the 10s of the second number. But before that, we need to add 0 in the 10 in the 1's place. And as 5 as we are carrying out multiplication with the digits in the 10's place. Now 5 multiplied by 2 gives 10. We write 0 in the 10's column and carry over 1 in the tens. So I cut this 0 and write under the tens place and carry over 1 into the chain. Next, gives 4. We add the 1 into the tens column to 4. We get 5. So we write 5 in the 100th column. Now 3 twos are gives 6. Since there is no carry over, we directly write 6 in the 1000th column. Finally, we have the two numbers together answer. So 0 plus 5, 5, 7 plus 0, 7, 9 plus 5, 14, So cut this 4 right under the 100th place. Carry over this 1 into the 1000th place. So 1 plus 6, 7. So our answer is 7475. Carry 325 passengers, therefore 23 aeroplanes carry 7475 passengers. Thank you, students.